It's party time. P-A-R-T-Y? Because I said so. Are you ready for the best damn ride of your life? Everybody, Joe here again with another Frag Report. Now, before I start this Frag Report, I have to say, shouts out to you, Dan, my makers, a fellow reviewer on YouTube. He has done a lot of reviews, I mean, a whole bunch of reviews, and he recently did a mini review on this scent, and it had me really intrigued. This scent is Hungry Hungry Hippies from Smellbang. Now, this isn't what this Frag Report is about. I just have to say, the man knows his stuff. This is actually a pretty good smell, great gourmand. For those of you who don't know, pretty much Hungry Hungry Hippies is a gourmand, which pretty much comes out to be like a weed brownie. It has some green notes, very chocolatey it is. If you enjoy gourmands, you need to check this out. Go to smellbent.com like I did. They ship rather quickly. So yeah. Before I start this Frag Report, I have to, absolutely have to say thank you to all of my current subscribers, all of my subscribers who have subscribed to me from the beginning all the way till the people who are hopefully still going to continue to subscribe to me as I continue putting out videos for you all. That being said, I want you guys to check out a really cool person. He's somewhat new as well to doing the videos. White Spirit Bear. White Spirit Bear. I'm sorry, my accent really gets in the way. Chad, thank you for your kind words in your Versace Arrows video. I appreciate it. Thanks to other reviewers as well, like Dance Bros, Steven, Vetalescence, Roger, Creed Frags, Greggy Boy, dude, those are Lex, Sebastian with Man Loves Cologne, Renee, Mr. Zayas. You recommended on the night out that I go ahead and pass on 1 million, which was my number one compliment getter at the time, at one point. And used what I like to call the Wonder Twins, which is Pure Malt and the regular Amen. That combination was such a great nightmare. So thank you as well. All, everybody, this whole community is awesome. That's all. I also want to say thank you to Al, the Fragrance Fanatic One. This is my last thank you. You don't know this, but it was actually your first, well, not your first video. Your top four winter list ended up being the first real reviewer video that I actually watched. If Gucci Guilty would have never failed, who knows where I would be today, pretty much. But I was like, you know what, Gucci Guilty, I can't take you anymore, I'm going on YouTube. I didn't even know that all of this existed until I saw his video, and I saw another one, and I saw a few more, but that video really, and then you brought Angel Men to my attention, which ended up being the second fragrance that I ended up purchasing. So, and then like a month later I got Pure Malt, and then the list goes on, and now we're here. So thank you, Al, for doing what you do and putting out that video. Thank you to everybody in FragCom. I mean, this is a great place. Everybody really supports everybody. And this is awesome. So yeah, thanks to all my subscribers once again. You guys really keep me wanting to put out more and more and more, because I mean, I was the one who would want to see the latest, want to see, hey, is there a review on this? No, there isn't. Bummer. Kind of have to try to, you know, find stuff out that way. And like I said, in Atlanta, it's a lot harder for us to get stuff. We don't have access to everything. We're pretty much like one of the last ones to find out anything. So all the subscribers, new and old, who continue to subscribe to my page, who were already a part of my page, thank you. All right, enough of me rambling. Let's go ahead and start this. Melbent is the house. It is like an indies niche kind of thing. Pretty affordable too. They have some great kinds of different crazy scents. I mean, for me to list them, but they are great people. This isn't a true unboxing, but they do give you cards to show their customer service personally. Joseph, that's my name. That's in case you didn't know, Joe is short for Joseph. Joseph, here's to a dynamite summer, fragrantly yours, and then they'll write the name of whoever handled your order. Awesome people. I will do business again. I'm probably gonna buy. And then they even included a little sample. I didn't ask for this. It's Totem Eclipse. They give you a nice little bit amount of juice for it. Tag on it. I might do a frag report on them. I'm not sure. Let's see. This one in particular really drew a lot of interest in me and kind of intrigued me just as much as Hungry Hungry Hippies. So this one is called Mountain High. They sell them in all kinds of sizes too. That's the other good thing about Smellbent. You could get them in like the little small thing like you're used to with Lucky Scent, which is what that Totem Eclipse was. You could get it in a 4 mil atomizer, a 5 mil, which is what I chose. They have like an 8 mil rollerball, which is also a perfume oil version. And I think they even have a 5 mil perfume version. Check the website, you'll be able to see. And they have like an actual bottle, 50 mil bottle for like $50. Pretty much most of their scents are about $50. And for the first time ever on a frag report, we have a spray sample. Went ahead and put a nice little bit amount. And it actually smells, I mean not smells, but sprays. Off of the initial spray, it comes off kind of slightly airy. Oh wow, this is this could definitely be how it says it is. This is like an aromatic. Off the initial spray, you get a kind of airy, like it's not thick and you know just there, slightly airy, so it's on the lighter side, of course, if this is supposed to be for the winter time, I mean the summertime. I smell a little bit of vanilla, tonka. I don't get the lavender, which is what drew me to this scent. For those of you who know I enjoy lavenders, this lavender isn't that prominent or as prominent as I would have thought it would have been, but it's there. It's kind of like The lavender is kind of like an offensive line for football. Like, you need it there, and it's there to be there, and you know it's there, but it doesn't do anything that, like, is a highlight of the game. The quarterback does all the work, the wide receivers, you know. The offensive linemen don't necessarily get the recognition. So that's kind of how this lavender is. So I'm getting a kind of vanilla tonka, kind of semi-green, and a little bit of woods. It's not like a woody scent, but there's woods there. If anything, the wood, like, if this had to be a football game right now, the vanilla is the quarterback. The greens, which is, this contains cannabis, a cannabis note, along with a couple of other green notes that I'm trying to have maybe patchouli. But yeah, so you have the vanilla tonka, which is like the quarterback, then you have the wide receivers, which are the greens. The lavender is just kind of there. This isn't a fruity scent. This is, I'm trying to think of what kind of scent could I compare it to, because it's not fruity. It is like a fresher kind of scent. It's good. I need more time with this. But it is, it's okay. It's nothing that has that wow factor, but I'm not unhappy that I bought this. Let's not get confused here. I'm not unhappy that I bought this, but this isn't really fully what I thought it would be, but that still does not mean that this isn't a good scent. I will give this more time. But overall, guys, you need to check Smell Bent out. They have a lot of great scents. They do. Looking into a couple other ones, Tokyo Mama Fizz or something like that. They have a few other ones that I'm definitely going to check out next. But these two, I kind of want to get these two out of the way. I definitely bought Hungry Hungry Hippies sample also. All right, everybody, that is my frag report on Mountain High. I could see what they did. They kind of took, you know, the mountain air, which made it aromatic and airy and lighter. They took the greens from, like, you know, the tree, you know, which contained cannabis instead, which was a nice, unique take. Maybe a little bit of patchouli in there. The vanilla to kind of be a soother, along with the lavender and the tonka. It's okay. I'll give it some more time. Possibly along with all of the people who I mentioned before. I'll put like a small description like on 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 days from now. Kind of just put how I really feel about it. It's kind of hard for me to really gauge at the moment, but Hungry Hungry Hippies, though, is also good. I enjoy it. Again, gourmand lovers, check it out. Scent of the day today, I finished off my sample from my very, very first video, my Pure Distance M. I enjoy it. I like it. Unfortunately, I might have to buy it. Let me know what your scent of the day was. Let me know if you've tried any Smell Bent before. Let me know if you've even tried Mountain High. I keep thinking it's Rocky Mountain High. Let me know if you've tried Mountain High. Or, you know, let me know if you do plan on trying Smell Bent, what kind of scent you want to smell. I'll let you know if... I'll I'm still trying to figure out if I'll go ahead and do a frag report on Totem Eclipse. Gotta decide on that. I have a lot of content coming out. I have a house spotlight actually that I plan on doing in the next 7 days. I am in school, so it might be a little bit difficult for me to go ahead and push that video out as far as this week, but in the next week to 10 days, I do plan on doing a house spotlight on a new house that nobody has brought to life. So, that being said, y'all take care. Check Smell Bent out. Check out the reviewers that I left. Party over.